everyone, my name is Palki Jain from Vidyan and Online, and if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then consider it right away.
Now, before understanding what is washing soda, first of all, we are going to understand what is water of crystallization. Okay. Now, there are certain salts that consist of water molecules as part of their structure. So, what do we mean by this? Say, suppose we have carbon dioxide. Okay. So, the structure of carbon dioxide consists of one carbon and two oxygen atom. Right. In a similar way, there are certain salts जिनके structure में ही आपको water molecules मिलेंगे, okay? वो उनके structure का part है. For example, if I talk about copper sulfate crystals, so copper sulfate crystal is CuSO4.5H2O, okay? So copper sulfate crystals के structure का part में ही ये 5 molecules of water है, right? ये कोई अलग से नहीं है, ये इसी के अंदर है. तो जिसके फॉर्मूले में ओके जिसके फॉर्मूले में जिसके स्ट्रक्चर में यू विल फाइंड मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर दो सॉल्ट्स वुड बी कॉल्ड एज हाइड्रेटेड सॉल्ट्स ओके सो ऑल द सॉल्ट्स दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशंस आर कॉल्ड हाइड्रेटेड सॉल्ट्स ओके नाउ लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग द कलर ऑफ दिस कॉपर सल्फेट क्रिस्टल्स आर ब्लू बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ दिस 5 मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन से सपोज अगर हम इसको हीट करते हैं तो हीट करने पे क्या होगा इसके 5 मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन विल बी लॉस्ट और आपको क्या मिलेगा सिर्फ कॉपर सल्फेट इन दैट वे द कलर ऑफ कॉपर सल्फेट क्रिस्टल विल ऑल्सो बी लॉस्ट इट वुड बी नो मोर अ ब्लू कलर ओके सो वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन एक्चुअली प्रोवाइड स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑल्सो कलर टू द सॉल्ट ओके सो अगर हम ये वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स को रिमूव कर देंगे तो देयर विल बी चेंज इन स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑल्सो इन चेंज इन कलर नाउ लेट अस सी सर्टेन सॉल्ट्स व्हिच कंसिस्ट ऑफ वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन एज अ पार्ट ऑफ देयर स्ट्रक्चर सो कैन यू गेस कि ग्रीन कलर के क्रिस्टल्स कौन से सॉल्ट के हैं यस दे बिलोंग फ्रॉम फेरस सल्फेट क्रिस्टल्स सो दे आर एक्चुअली फेरस सल्फेट क्रिस्टल Containing 7 molecules of water of crystallization. The second is copper sulfate crystals. Isme kya hai? Its formula is copper sulfate dot 5H2O. It means it consists of 5 molecules of water of crystallization. Next, this is calcium sulfate crystals. So this is basically gypsum, which we are going to study in the next session. Okay. And it consists of 2 molecules of water of crystallization. Now, this is sodium carbonate crystals which consist of 10 molecules of water of crystallization and thus it is washing soda which we are going to study just now. Now here is one important thing I need to tell you that the water of crystallization is not free water. So if any salt contains water of crystallization then it doesn't mean that the salt is wet. So aisa nahi hai ki ye sare salts jinke andar aap ye water molecules dekh rahe ho ye sare wet hain. Aisa nahi hai. In fact salt containing water of crystallization appears to be perfectly dry. Okay. So kabhi bhi confuse mat karna ki isme water of crystallization hai to ye wet honge. Now let us talk about sodium carbonate crystals that consist of 10 molecules of water of crystallization. So this is sodium carbonate decahydrate. Why deca? Deca means because this is 10 molecules of water of crystallization. Okay, that is why formula comes out to be Na2CO3.10H2O. Okay, so it is sodium carbonate containing 10 molecules of water of crystallization is actually washing soda. Okay. Now, the washing soda that doesn't contain any water of crystallization is called anhydrous sodium carbonate. Anhydrous means that it won't contain any molecules of water of crystallization. It would be only Na2CO3. Okay. So, let us understand how we are going to prepare this. So, the way we prepared baking soda in the similar way, we are going to prepare the washing soda. From the uppermost part, you will be feeding sodium chloride solution along with ammonia, and that is why it is called ammonical brine. And from the downwards, you will be feeding carbon dioxide gas. they all will mix up slowly in order to form sodium hydrogen carbonate and ammonium chloride. And then we are going to filter it in order to obtain NaHCO3. Okay, so this is the first step in the preparation of washing soda. Now let us see the steps which are involved in the formation of washing soda. So the first step is formation of sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is NaHCO3. Now NaHCO3 being solid precipitate will be filtered out and it is then heated in order to form sodium carbonate. Now this sodium carbonate is actually anhydrous, yeah, because it doesn't contain any molecules of water. So then what happens is it undergoes recrystallization. It means it reacts with water in order to form sodium carbonate decahydrate. So we'll see the steps one by one. So step number one, in which the brine is reacting with ammonia. So brine is what? It is NaCl plus water. So kabhi bhi agar brine ki baat karte hain to wo kya hoga? Concentrated solution of कॉमन सॉल्ट. तो कॉमन सॉल्ट ज्यादा होगा, पानी कम होगा, उसका जो सॉल्यूशन होगा वो होगा ब्राइन. उसको हम रिएक्ट करेंगे अमोनिया से, ठीक है. इससे हमें क्या मिलेगा? विल गेट बेकिंग सोडा विच इज NaHCO3 अलोंग विद अमोनियम क्लोराइड विच इज NH4Cl. ओके, नाउ दिस बेकिंग सोडा इज एक्चुअली इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट एंड दस इट सेटल्स डाउन इन बॉटम एंड यू कैन फिल्टर इट आउट इन ऑर्डर टू गेट NaHCO3. So in the next step, what we are going to do is, in the next step we are going to obtain sodium carbonate from sodium hydrogen carbonate. For this we are going to heat it. So NaHCO3, when it is heated, what you will get? You will get Na2CO3, which is sodium carbonate, along with carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So as to balance it, I'll put 2 here. Okay. So whenever you have carbonate in the reactant, you will always have carbon dioxide in the product. Okay. Now the sodium carbonate doesn't contain any water of crystallization. So in the last step, what we are going to do is, we are going to do recrystallization of sodium carbonate. Kaise karenge? By reacting it with 10 molecules of water. So hame kya milega? Na2CO3 dot 10H2O. Okay, and this is what? This is washing soda. Okay, so in 3 steps you are going to obtain washing soda. And again, washing soda is actually prepared from sodium chloride only. Next, let us see the properties of washing soda. So it is actually a transparent crystalline solid. Okay, so washing soda is actually transparent in color. Next, it is soluble in water. So actually washing soda is among very few carbonates which are soluble in water. Now let us see what will happen when washing soda is heated. So the formula for washing soda is Na2CO3.10H2. Okay, so what will happen when you heat it? So once you heat it, it will lose its 10 molecules of water of crystallization and will have Na2CO3 along with 10 molecules of water. Okay, now since this doesn't contain any of the water molecules, that is why it is called soda ash. Okay, it is called soda ash or anhydrous sodium carbonate. Now next is action of air. So we are going to understand what will happen if you keep washing soda exposed to air. तो अभी क्या है? Washing soda है जो आपने air में छोड़ रखा है for long period of time. तो क्या होता है? So in this you are going to understand the term efflorescence. So what happens is when washing soda, which is Na2CO3.10H2O, is kept in air for long period of time. It is exposed to air. Okay. So it will lose its 9 molecules of water and you will have only Na2CO3.H2O, only 1 molecule of water of crystallization, and 9 molecules of water of crystallization will be lost. And this is actually called as sodium carbonate monohydrate. And the sodium carbonate monohydrate is actually a white powder that is formed on the surface of washing soda crystals. And this process of losing water of crystallization is called efflorescence. Next, washing soda have cleansing property. So if you talk about a dirty substance, a dirty cloth, so it will have grease and oil stains in it, right? So grease and oil are not naturally water soluble, but if you add this dirty clothes containing grease and oil into the washing soda solution, then the washing soda will attack this dirt and grease, making them water soluble product, which is then washed away on rinsing with water. So actually, washing soda makes the grease and oil water soluble. Now let us see the uses of washing soda. So under this, the first use is that it is used for removing hardness of water, right? So the water which we actually get from mountain contain dissolved calcium and magnesium salt, which makes it very hard. Now when you add washing soda into the hard water containing calcium and magnesium ions, then what will happen is sodium carbonate decahydrate will react with those calcium and magnesium ion and make it insoluble. So kya hota hai, when these ions react with sodium carbonate, then you will have insoluble compounds of calcium and magnesium which settles down in the bottom and is then filtered out. Next, it is used in the manufacture of glass. So in the industry where you manufacture the glass, washing soda is actually one of the most important ingredient. Okay, and when you mix this washing soda with silica, you actually get soft glass. Okay, now let us see the third use of it. So it is used in the manufacture of soap. So as I told you, washing soda has the capability to make oil and grease soluble in water. That is why it is used in the manufacture of soap and as well as detergents. Now the last use is that it is used in the manufacture of sodium components such as borax. So what is borax? Borax is basically a compound that is used in medicines in order to control pests or insects or kill cockroaches and ants. So basically most of the sodium component is made from washing soda. Okay, so we have completed this topic of washing soda. I hope you must have enjoyed this session. Now I am going to meet you in the next session, in which we are going to study about plaster of Paris. Till then, bye bye and take care of yourself.